What a delightful morning. And here I am down in Devon, the land of my birth, walking past the landmark, as we called it, or the Daymark, as they seem to want to call it now. And I'm going to walk along the coast from Brownstone Battery, battery being a gun battery, to Kingswear. So picked a good morning for it. It's not all good down here, having had a flawless journey down the motorway. Of course, I arrive here and it's kids are going to school, traffic is absolutely rammed, and of course we're on the little roads, which anyway, hopefully it'll be a great day. Nearly forgot to say that this stretch of road here, or lane, or whatever you want to call it, was where I first learnt to ride a bicycle. I was out here with the scouts, and one of the guys lent me his bike and see what I made of it, and I taught myself to ride a bike.
This 80-foot tower is known as the Daymark. In my day, it used to be known as the Landmark, and it was built in the 1860s by the Dartmouth Harbour Commission. The mouth of the River Dart is notoriously difficult to identify from out at sea, so this tower was built to guide shipping into the estuary of the river.
Back in World War II, they built a gun battery down here that I understand never saw any action. But imagine spending your war here. The view here of the mouth of the River Dart, estuary, looking right out to Start Point on the end of that headland. And the long beach you can see there is Slapton Sands, which is where the Americans rehearsed for D-Day in Operation Tiger. You won't be able to see the steepness of this road. It doesn't work on the camera, but believe me, I'd rather be walking down than walking up. Although, let's face it, if you do walk down, eventually you do have to walk up. Anyway, we'll see. Be walking around to the River Dart estuary eventually, but it's at the moment, it's the sea is as calm as a millpond, as they say. Here are some of the buildings that comprise what they now called Froward Point. We now have a voluntary Coast Guard station here, but all these were World War II buildings. I guess it was where people used to sleep and keep stuff. And in front of the Coast Guard station, there is a stunning view. I can remember many years ago, when my dad was a scout leader, we came out here and stayed the night. In these buildings, lying on hay and stuff. So this is the mouth of the River Dart. Looking out to Start Point. And here we have the Mew Stone. I can remember being out here many times. And smelling the gorse flowers, a sort of like a coconut type of aroma. See a fishing boat in the distance. Absolutely stunning morning. What a stunning view this is. Following the footpath now to Kingswear. Rather like the buildings you see in Normandy, I imagine these will be here for a very long time. Nice and shady in here before we hit the open part. We always used to describe this area as rather snaky. A kissing gate. A few steps here they've built. Try and protect the path. It's been a few years since I've done this. In fact, last year when I was down here, and I was up in the woods, I took a bit of a tumble. I need to make sure that doesn't happen this time. Otherwise, it will be a question of what three words. What goes down must come up. Some of this has been on fire. No idea how that started. Nice place to put a seat. Lovely. When we were kids, we used to call this Robin Hood's Cove. I don't know if they still call it that, but we used to come out of the mouth of the river in our boats, bring our lunch with us. Rather easier access than trying to climb down through these snaky cliffs. But again, there's been some fire here. I don't know when this would have been. This is all a little bit slippery here and on a steep slope. But I thought I would show you these. These are sloes. And sloes grow on the blackthorn bush. And this is what they use to make sloe gin. Just met some people who have walked from Dartmouth and are going to do the round trip. Fair play to them. I mean, I could do it, but it's all a matter of time, and I've got other things to do. Other fish to fry today. Another steep little section here. I was hoping to send the drone up again, actually, but rather too many trees. I'm not that good a pilot. More evidence of burning. To remember me and my old mate, Kevin Giles, we came out here once deciding we were going to acquire, shall we say, our own Christmas tree. And as we poached our two Christmas trees, we had to flatten ourselves into the undergrowth because there was some kind of truck coming along here. A little all-wheel drive type thing. Anyway, we had to... Once we'd got the trees, it was then a question of getting them home without being seen. So we hid them and came back at night. God, look at this. Beautiful trees. I hope they're secure. Somebody's asked me if I thought it was arson but there's burning in lots of areas. This one here is burnt. Looks to me like it's a natural thing. We had some very dry weather, I think in July, hot. May have happened then. Up here as well. Just walking along here, you can see the blue-green of the River Dart and the mouth of the river. Looks absolutely gorgeous. To my land full of rainy skies and gales, and I shall be aboard that ship tomorrow. What a view. Fantastic. You are beautiful, and I have loved you dearly, more dearly than the spoken word can tell. For you are beautiful, and I have loved you dearly, more dearly than the spoken word. Just coming down these steps now into Mill Bay. Tractor over here across the valley. So just coming down now to what is the old mill of Mill Bay, but we used to think it was a castle, and when we were kids we used to play on it and in it. Now, as you can see, health and safety has gone mad. It's dangerous. You mustn't do it. Those looks like some people have tried to ignore it, but they clearly don't want you in there. Little stream here. Heading down to the sea. And here with our picnics. We'd be gone all day. Parents never used to have a clue where we were. And when we were old enough to have boats, we used to time it right with the tides, and we would come out here in our little boats. Had many happy memories down on this beach, cooking sausages, picnicking, boating, messing about in this old mill, which is we used to call a castle. Absolutely brilliant. So this is Mill Bay, the little valley, and over here is what we used to call the castle, where we used to play. Used to have some brilliant times out here. These steps are where it now gets a little bit challenging. It was always the same. Again, the camera doesn't tell the whole story, I'm afraid. I thought I'd got to the top, and then I saw this. Jeez. Back when we were kids, though, there was no cover here, so you had, and there weren't any steps either, so you just had a path and the baking hot sun to contend with. Gee. So back to a degree of civilization. Aircraft buzzing around from the Royal Naval College, I assume. This area of Kingswear is called Fountain Violet. Now, isn't that nice? And this rather ornate gate goes to mark the Fountain Violet piece of road. This beautiful place here is called Brook Hill. And back in World War II, many of the Free French were stationed here, including President de Gaulle, or the future president. General de Gaulle, perhaps I should have said. Fantastic view. I'm sure they had a rather nice time here, albeit they were involved in some dangerous work as part of the secret fleet that used to sail over to France to bring back downed airmen and spies, etc. I don't think I've ever walked this road before when it's got asphalt on it. Years ago, Lindsay and I had our first experience of motorcycling when this was just a farm track. And we used to ride up and down on our NSU quickly. In the end, I bought it off Lindsay. I think it was for £5. I didn't keep it for long. It was too slow and unreliable. So I sold it I got myself the Honda C110, which was equally slow. Well, not equally, but it was my introduction to motorcycling, I guess, back in about 1968. Nice view of the mouth of the river here. Dartmouth Castle behind those trees. The farm down at the bottom of this track where I've just walked up from was owned by a Mr. Valance, who was a dairy farmer, and he had a stand up here where he would leave his churns of milk to be collected. Don't know whether it's still here. I'm going to say that's where the milk stand was, but it's been moved or taken away, which is a bit of a shame, really. Anyway, I'm now going to walk down this way into Kingswear from the top. One of Kingswear's most stunning views. The river, the what some call an eyesore of a marina, but it brings money to the town. Well, I say the town, I mean Dartmouth rather than Kingswear. The Royal Naval College in the distance. Lovely. Just rounding the corner here to the top of Kingswear, where we have some of the most stunning views that any social housing project, as Americans would call it, could possibly have. This blue building on the right here are flats, apartments that were built as social housing. A lot of them now are privately owned, but they can only be owned by people who live in Devon. And below here, I can see it from here, these houses here were also council houses or social housing. Not a lot of good that this thing being here. It needed to be out on the cliffs. If only I'd known. Every inch of the village has been infilled with housing. Such a shame. The place has just changed beyond all recognition, really. So here are the other council houses, social housing. But what a view, eh? What a view.